what is it, how to organize, or the how, what is, what constitutes organized plunder? What constitutes organized plunder? And this plunder, the case of the water sector, began in 1994. Now, prior to 1994, the Jabatan Bukan Air Selangor was managing water in the state of Selangor. And if you go back and look at the archives, you will find that the revenue stream from the Jabatan Bekal Air Selangor was anywhere between 50, 60, 70, 80 million ringgit. At one year, I think it was 91, it hit 91 million ringgit. And water was a big contributor to the coffers of the Selangor state government. Anywhere between the first, second, third, fourth, very high level of contribution from water to the state coffers of the state perbendaharaan Selangor. The question is, why do you privatize a profit-making public utility company? I don't have to tell you why, you can guess it already. But why, the question for Malaysians is, why do you privatize and continue to support them till now? First question is, why privatize a public utility when it's making profits? And why continue to support them, provide them further license, and bail them out even more, even after they have been inefficient? So why the organized plunder, why the organized bailout? The answer, of course, will unravel as we speak. But how was the plunder organized? How was the plunder organized? The plunder was organized in the following way. As Dr. Subra mentioned just now, there are three broad components in the water distribution. One, of course, raw water. Second is distribution. And second is treatment plants. Third is distribution. Now, water goes to the treatment plants. Treatment plants treat the water, and then it goes to our house, to pipes, and so on and so forth. As any water person will tell you, or somebody who works in the water works will tell you, or we are also quite familiar, that the profits actually come from the treatment plant. And the loss-making part is always the distribution part, because you have to buy pipes, you have to pay workers, the non-revenue water is very high, and there's lots of maintenance, and so on and so forth. So what happens is, when the state was running it, when the state under Jabatan Bukan Air Selangor was running it, the profits from the treatment side will be used to subsidize the distribution part. And still they can make 50, 60, 70, and 80 million dollars profits. Ringgit, I say dollars means anything, ringgit profit. So what the state government in 1994, 1995, and subsequently, what they did was, they privatized, well, I should ask you, how do you think they made the money? How do you think they did it? How did they actually handle the whole privatization at that time? Do you think they privatized the profitable part or the non-profitable part? The profitable part. So what they did was, they gave the profitable part to the private contractors, the private utility, water utility players, and they were linked politically to the state government of Selangor at that time to UMNO. At that time, the minister was, chief minister, Alexander Besar, was on my side. And of course, everybody in UMNO knows, I'm not telling you anything you don't know yet, is close to the chairman of Santiago. So therefore, the state government of Selangor at that time handed over the profitable assets of the state to the private sector, namely the UMNO cronies. So this is an organized blunder in order to support cronies and UMNO itself. That's why when Subra said, every time you drink water or you flush your toilet, you're contributing money to UMNO. But that doesn't mean you don't have to go toiletless, you have to. But it doesn't give you an impression where the money is going. Some of it is going. Now, that's how the story started. And let me just talk to you about what are some of the implications that we have in terms of concession. Is Shabazz an efficient provider of water? Is Shabazz, a public utility that is efficient.